What's up, guys? In this tutorial, I will show you the best settings for Free Fire on your iOS or Android device. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. Tap on the gear icon on the top right of your main menu to access your Free Fire settings. The basic settings allow you to make changes to your account and download settings. Under Account, you have the option to connect one of the shown services to your Free Fire account in order to keep your account safe and make it easier to transfer to another device. Below, you have the option to change your in-game language. This will require you to restart the game and download a new language pack. When selecting to show the main menu entrance, then you can access your download center from your main menu, which we will cover later in this guide. After taking a look at all of your settings, you have the ability to upload your settings preset or download a previously saved one to be applied to your game. Lastly, you have the option to clear your browser cache for the game, as well as the chat blacklist. In the Sensitivity tab, you can change your sensitivity settings when moving around, when using a red dot, and so on. It's suggested to optimize these settings to your personal preference while in a private match to improve your gaming experience in the long run. Under Controls, you have the option to enable or disable some buttons while playing the game. Most of these default settings should be left like this when starting out with Free Fire. You might want to enable the Quick Reload option, as well as Auto Parachute. I prefer to use the Drag Run mode, as I have to tap on fewer buttons when playing the game, but this will come down to personal preference. Enable the Kill Notifications if you want, which are disabled by default. The Visual Effects option is set to No Blood by default, so you might want to change this option as well. After taking a look at these control settings, tap on Custom HUD on the bottom right. Here, you have the option to change the transparency and size for each button and HUD element. You can also hold and drag the buttons to their desired location. After making changes to this layout, you should make sure to save it as a preset for future use. When this is done, navigate to your auto pickup settings. Here, you can change which items will be picked up automatically when running over them in a match. On the top right, you can also adjust the pickup priority for all the important items in the game. Simply use the arrow icons on the right-hand side to change the position of the item. Navigate to your Display Settings tab, which will have a lot of impact on the performance and quality of your gameplay. I will set these for a low to mid-end device, as it will in turn also reduce distractions generated by the game and will help you run Free Fire smoothly on any mobile device you wish to use. Set your graphics option to Smooth or Standard. Smooth should be the best option for low-end devices, as it uses the least amount of resources to run the game properly on a high refresh rate. When using the Ultra option, you will be able to make use of some additional settings, which will in most cases further induce lag and FPS drops. I will set this option to Standard on my iPhone 11 Pro Max, but for any older or less powerful device, make sure to use Smooth. Next, enable the High FPS option. This will allow the game to max out the FPS value according to your device's screen refresh rate. The minimap options below will have no impact on the game's performance, so set this option according to your preference. In your sound settings, make sure to adjust your volume sliders. I prefer to reduce the music volume to a minimum, and set the voice volume a bit higher than the sound effects. Lastly, in your notification settings, you have the choice of which kind of notifications should appear in-game. You can then exit your settings and tap on the download icon in your main menu. Here, in your download center, you can download or delete downloaded content from the game. When tapping on your avatar icon on the top left of your screen, you can access your player information settings. Here, change the nickname, language, gender, and other player information if you want to. Under Style and the Battle Cards tabs, you can further personalize how your player will appear when being looked up. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.